Welcome back to ActivePresenter tutorial series. When it comes to video editing features, ActivePresenter provides you a powerful timeline as you can see on the screen. But most importantly, it's not just designed for editing video. Rather, you can make the most easy timeline to customize audio tracks as well. This is also what I want to share with you today. To demonstrate, I will insert an audio to my working project. There are two ways to insert an audio in ActivePresenter: importing an existing file from the computer and recording your own audio file. Let's get started with importing audio from a file. First, in the Annotation tab, click Audio and then click From File. Let's listen to this audio. In the case of an object, you can also click the audio icon to add audio from library. You can see this icon in the audio section of the Properties pane. If you have a microphone connected to your computer, you can record your own voice in the real time to be included on a slide. Here are some steps to record a new audio. In the Annotation tab, click Audio, and then click Create New. Immediately, a vertical blue line appears on the timeline. Next, go to the audio section. Click the recording icon to capture the sound. Click the microphone icon to adjust volume. Click the blue icon to end the recording. Click camera input to set the microphone or recording device to the correct recording level. In the case of converting text to speech, you can copy and paste your text into the text-to-speech box and click Generate. After that, a new timebar appears on the timeline as you can see. With ActivePresenter, you can capture the voice narrations as well. Note that ActivePresenter will record your voice while playing the slide simultaneously, and your recording will start from the playhead position. To do that, click the red icon in the timeline.
Welcome to the first video in the Beginner Guitar Restart series.
Once finishing, click the Stop button. Similarly, from the drop-down menu, you can also change input device, calibrate the recording sound, and adjust volume. When a slide contains narration, text-to-speech, and system audio or audio track, the timeline displays different waveform bars as you can see on the screen. After adding an audio to a slide, you can preview and edit it in the timeline with some following techniques. First, select a range of the audio you want to edit. Click Cut, Copy, Delete, and Crop to apply advanced editing for the audio. Click Insert Time to add an interval of silence, the silence inserted at the playhead. Click Adjust Volume to increase or decrease the sound level of the audio file. Which is true, we create a video tutorial helping you to get full understanding about how exactly it works. And you can find it on our tutorial page or YouTube channel. Finally, if you want to remove any audio in your slide, just select the waveform bar that audio and press the delete key on the keyboard. Now you know how to insert an audio into a specific slide or an object in ActivePresenter. Follow us on our community, blog, Facebook, and YouTube to get more useful tutorials about designing e-learning courses and screencasts. Start your journey with ActivePresenter right now and feel the difference. Thank you for watching.